Speak Student!
SAS, ASA, and AAS, a la Shmoop. Henry has always been a proficient wizard, but lately it seems all of his potions have been turning out a little funky. Henry is setting out to solve the problem logically. First, he double-checks his ingredients. They all seem to be in order. Next, his spellbook. Looks fine. Finally, his two hourglasses. If the two halves of the hourglasses are differently shaped or incongruent, the timing will be all off. Henry may have found the problem. Now, the fastest way for Henry to determine congruency would be just to measure all the sides and angles. Unfortunately, Henry lost his measuring tools, and he only has a few measurements originally provided by the hourglass manufacturers to work with, as well as three very useful geometric rules. Each hourglass can be divided into two triangles, one standing upside down on the other. One rule for determining congruency between triangles is the side-angle-side rule, or SAS, which states, if two sides and the angle between them of one triangle are congruent to the corresponding parts of another triangle, the triangles are congruent. For the smaller hourglass, Henry has the measurements of two of the sides, 5 inches and 8 inches, and 5 inches and 8 inches. The measurements are equal, so the sides are congruent. Ding ding. We can use hash marks to keep track of congruent parts. As for the angle between them, Henry can use the vertical angle theorem to conclude that the angles are also congruent. So by the SAS rule, the two triangular halves of this hourglass are congruent. Another rule for determining triangular congruency is the angle-side-angle rule, or ASA, which states, if two angles and the side between them of one triangle are congruent to the corresponding parts of another triangle, the triangles are congruent. The triangles of Henry's second hourglass have congruent corresponding angle measurements, but that doesn't prove congruency because the two halves might still be different sizes. So Henry measures the bases. Yeah, there they go. They're congruent. Since the bases lie between congruent corresponding angles, the two halves of this hourglass are congruent by the ASA rule. Related to the ASA rule is the angle-angle-side theorem, or AS. Oh, that's AAS, that is. Which states, if two angles and an adjacent side of one triangle are congruent to the corresponding parts of another triangle, the triangles are congruent. This theorem is a bit of a shortcut because it helps save a few steps in any proof. Namely, if you know two angle measurements of any triangle, you can easily find the third. Looks like there isn't really anything wrong with the shape of Henry's hourglasses. Back to the drawing board.